Alrighty, it is that time again. I am going to share this into my group. We are live. Hello. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me for another live training. Today, it's all about why are we so darn afraid of being on camera? And it's a very real thing, so let's just get rid of all of these fears right now, shall we? My name is Karin Carr. I am a realtor in Savannah, Georgia, for those of you that don't know me. And I make YouTube videos to attract clients to my business. It is so effective for me that it's pretty much all that I do. I don't hold open houses. I don't farm neighborhoods. I don't run tons of ads. I don't cold call. I don't door knock. I don't do all the things. I literally just make videos to attract people to my business. And it's a freaking awesome business model. Let me just tell you, I like to attract business rather than chase it. But I remember what it was like in the beginning. My videos were awful. I didn't know anything about lighting. I didn't know anything about sound. I didn't know anything about sets. The office where I used to record, I lived in Atlanta at the time, and it was like a dark, like coffee with cream color on the walls. It had one big window that faced, I think it faced east. So anytime from like 10 in the morning on, it was kind of dark in that room. I didn't have a microphone. Like I didn't have anything. I was just kind of winging it, but I did it anyway because I didn't know any better and I didn't let it stop me. I didn't let the lack of technology stop me. But the whole time that I was recording, because I didn't really know what I was going to say, I didn't have anything written down. I was just kind of winging it. I'd be rambling and rambling. And eventually I'd just be thinking, oh my God, this is so bad. Why am I still talking? I should just stop and start over again. So can any of you relate to that? Because I know that so many people tell me, like I travel the country talking about making videos to get business for yourself. And I hear this over and over and over again from you guys that they know that video is the place to be. They know they need to be doing it, but they just can't get over that initial hurdle of being too afraid to be on camera. So I know that it works. I've seen it in my own business. I've seen it in my students' business. And I just can't allow you to continue to tell that story to yourself. So that's what we're going to talk about today. So let me ask you a question. Let's say that you have a pediatrician that you just love. They are so good with your kids. You love this doctor. Even when you take the kids to the doctor, they're not afraid to see them. They don't mind. They're happy going to the doctor. Not a problem. Or maybe you feel that way about your CPA. The CPA does such a good job for you. When they do your taxes, you're like, score, I didn't have to write a big fat check for $20,000 this year to the IRS. Or maybe it's even your hairstylist, the person that cuts your hair. They do a phenomenal job in your hair and you wouldn't dream of going to anybody else. Does it matter whether or not they're a little soft around the middle? Does it matter that they've got some little crinkles right here? And I'm not going to call them wrinkles. I'm going to call them crinkles because they come from smiling. So in my book, they're a good thing. Do you care? Do you care what they look like? If they are good at their job, you trust them implicitly, you want to keep using their services, do you really care what they look like? You don't, right? It doesn't matter what they look like. The point is that they do a good job for you and you trust them and they are helping you. They are making your life better. Does it really matter what they look like? It doesn't. So why are we so concerned with what people think that we look like? Listen, if somebody calls you and says, hi, I found you in, I don't know, the Yellow Pages. Do they still have that? They call you and say, I found you. I just got pre-approved for $500,000. I'm ready to go house hunting. I want to buy a house this weekend. Are you really going to say, I'm sorry, I can't leave my house right now because I need to lose 10 pounds? Of course not. So why would we dream of letting that stop us making a video? It's the same thing. It's just that we're on a video instead of meeting them face to face. So don't worry so much about what you look like. Yes, if you're going to be recording a video, get up, get dressed, make yourself presentable. Dress however it is that you normally dress when you're meeting with clients. Try to have your room looking okay, not a complete pigsty. Don't be wearing pajamas. But other than that, you are who you are and you look like what you look like. I went to a great presentation. It was at the BombBomb Rehumanize conference last year, and I can't remember who it was, but he said how he gets over his fear of being on camera. He's got this hashtag, and it's hashtag this is my face. And it's true. This is your face. This is what you look like. If somebody really doesn't want to work with you because of what you look like, do you want to work with that person anyway? I would venture to say, no, you don't. We don't want to work with people that are that shallow, right? We want to work with people who genuinely want and need our services. And if they're that caught up on what you look like, then good riddance to them, right? Here's another analogy. Let's say that you and your family go to Baskin Robbins for ice cream. They got 31 flavors, right? Now, rum raisin to me is the grossest flavor on the face of the earth. I could never force myself to eat rum raisin ice cream any time. Like, can't do it. But there've got to be people out there that like rum raisin because they keep making this flavor and they keep selling this flavor. Now, if you are rum raisin ice cream, does everybody in the whole world have to like rum raisin ice cream in order for you to be valuable? No, only the people that love rum raisin ice cream might want to order you, but that's okay. You don't need everybody to love you. You only need the people that really want what it is that you have to offer. So when you're making your videos, and if you're going to take my 5-day challenge, please sign up for that. I'll have the link down below. It's going to start on February 24th, which is a week from Monday, I believe. And one of the things we talk about is finding out who your ideal client is, picking a niche, picking a specialty, picking a niche if you're fancy. I always say the riches are in the niches, and niche don't rhyme with riches. So we talk about picking a niche and how you appeal to the certain type of person that you are trying to attract. So you don't have to attract everybody. You do not need to have a YouTube channel that will attract every single person that wants to buy or sell a house in your entire market area. Doing that, of course, that will be scary if you're thinking, oh my gosh, the population of my area is 100,000 people or 500,000 or millions of people. Of course, that's going to be scary. We're only trying to attract that one specific type of person, and they're naturally going to like you because of the way that you show up on camera. So if you're trying to attract somebody and you're displaying your real personality on camera, they are going to automatically like you because they're drawn to your personality type anyway. So it kind of takes all the pressure off when you know that your ideal person is the person who's meant to see this video. And if they keep watching, I think it's safe to assume that they like you, because if they didn't like you, they wouldn't keep watching all of your videos, right? So we've talked about those two things. The other thing is that while your channel is small, it's kind of sad, but nobody's really watching. Right? While your channel is small and you have 7 subscribers and all of your videos are getting like 9 views and the only people watching are your best friend and your mom, that is okay, because that is the time that we are honing our skills. That's where we're learning what to say on camera and where to look. For example, I am looking at the camera lens. I've seen lots of people that kind of look over here because they're watching themselves on their phone screen. But you got to look at the lens, right? We don't know that instinctively. We have to learn that stuff. And when you're learning all that stuff, you don't have a lot of people watching the video. So it's okay. It kind of takes the pressure off. You will get better. I promise you will get better over time. The sheer repetition of making videos over and over and over again, you can't help but get better and learn a few things along the way. And that's when the views and the subscribers start coming. And if anybody really wants to go back and watch your earliest content, I left all mine up there. I've seen no reason to delete it. And I've had multiple people say, oh my gosh, you have gotten so much better over time. Like, your early videos, they were pretty rough, but now look at you. And they admire that. They admire seeing our journey and how far that we've come and how much better we've gotten. And nobody ever says, I was thinking of hiring you as my realtor, but I watched your old videos and man, you sucked on camera. So therefore I'm not going to hire you after all. No one ever, ever says that. We build up this story in our own minds and it's not true. The story that you're telling yourself is not true. If the story is people are going to ridicule me based on what I look like, people are not going to like me, people will not watch me, people will think that I'm boring. If those are the stories that you're telling yourself, they're not true. You need to change that story. The story is, I am good at what I do. I am here to help my clients. They are lucky to have me. They would be lucky to have an agent as dedicated as I am that would help them and bend over backwards for them. And they are going to be grateful when they stumble across my content. They're going to pick up the phone and call me. They're going to hire me. It's going to be a fantastic transaction. Like, that is the story that you want to tell yourself, because the more you say it, the more you start to believe it. And once you believe it, you act as though it's already true. And that, my friends, is manifestation at work. When you already believe it and you act as though it's already true, it becomes true. And so that's what I want you to start doing. Tell yourself how good you are. Tell yourself that people would be lucky to find your content. And start to believe it, because eventually it will become true. So I encourage you to not let your fear of camera get the best of you and stop you from doing this. I get probably 70% of my closings from people that find me on YouTube. I have a small team. We support ourselves by making YouTube videos. This is where the vast majority of our business comes from, without spending money on ads and without wasting hours and hours and hours a week doing things that just don't bring in a ton of revenue, or spending thousands of dollars a month buying leads. And if you didn't see the video I did last week, go and watch that one where I talk about the danger of buying leads. So again, my challenge starts Monday, February 24th. It's called Turn Subscribers into Sales. We're going to talk about not only the process of making videos, but the way that you do it so that it makes people not just watch the video and go, oh, him. He's kind of cool. It makes him say, you know what? We need to hire a realtor to sell our house and let's call this guy. So I will include that link for you so that you can sign up. And next week is my final live before the 5-day Turn Subscribers into Sales Challenge starts. We're going to be talking about how to avoid overwhelm and burnout. Because I know we feel like there's so many things to do and just not enough hours in the day. And how do you decide what is most important? What things will move the needle for your business? What things will bring in revenue so that you don't have to work so freaking hard? That's what we're talking about next Wednesday, 3 p.m. Eastern. I hope you'll join me then. And in the meantime, have a great week, everyone.